because we're professionals here. Yes. Actually, I've already started streaming and I've just said that. Hello! Hello, everybody. This is the Escapist Magazine, and today we're going to be doing some character creation with the Fate Core system created by Evil Hat Productions. And now my phone is telling me that we've just started streaming. Well done, phone. I'm going to be joined today by my players for the... well, they're not players yet. They're still... Well, they are players, but they don't have characters yet. I'm joined by Ronald Diplat.
Hello.
I'm joined by Sasha Ninny.
Hello.
And I'm joined via text by Wolf Venom, who unfortunately you can't see the text of until I actually start streaming the game board we'll be using. But I assure you, he does say hi. Wolf Venom, say hi! He's shy. Anyway, we're going to be doing character creation today. The guys have already had a look through the lists of thingamabobs. That will do. The list of character attributes that they can have for their species and so forth. There you go. Wolf Venom says hi. We're going to be doing it via Roll20 most of the time, and I'll be walking through them step by step. Now, I know Sasha Ninny has to go at some point in the not too distant future, so I'm going to be focusing on doing their sheet first, and I will work with other people as we go along. So, first of all, let me just open up my own instructions on how to do this properly, so I don't completely mess this up. Yep, you can see my instructions are written in Notepad. Really high tech here. So everybody, you've got your character sheets available to you, yes?
Yeah.
You yes. Had a look through the species list, which I... Oh, that's the wrong one. There we go. Which I am currently showing off to our viewers. I will make this one available in the Discord channel so that people can actually go through and see what we've been doing. And you've all picked out a species which you want to go with from this list, I take it?
Yeah.
Okay. Keep in mind that species and the stunt you want for later on. For now, we leave that aside, okay?
Okay.
All right.
Because for now, we're going to look at the aspects of your character. So if you would turn to your character sheet.
Yes.
We need to focus on, first of all, the your high concept aspect. This is the core of your character, who they are at their absolute heart. When it all goes to shit, what are they? Do they turn and run? Do they stand tall? Are they focused purely on profit? Are they interested solely in themselves? Are they would they turn around and try and help everybody else before themselves? What are they at their core? So if we start with Sasha on this one, do you have any idea what you want to do with your character in this sense?
Well, the closest I can then come to that kind of thing is that basically he is going on this adventure because he thinks it's going to be fun.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he's in it because it amuses him.
Okay, so maybe something like Thrill Seeker or Amusement Seeker or... Oh, what would be a good term for that? What species is he again?
He is a rat, a Nightwalker specifically. Okay.
So he's going to be maybe something like a... pleasure-seeking rat. We need to have a pithy way of describing it. The Fate system tends to work best when you've got something you can use later on, because the aspects become critical later on in the game when you're trying to use your fate points to improve roles or avoid major consequences. So you want something...
The closest I can come to term for that would be a hedonist of some kind.
Okay, so maybe a rat hedonist or a... Ooh. Hmm. for now, how about just go with hedonist, and we can expand upon it later on and refine it down, because again, with the fate system, you can easily change things around.
Okay.
Okay. Now your trouble aspect. Unfortunately, for this, unfortunately for this, I'm pretty sure that hedonist would fit pretty well as well. The trouble aspect is the fatal flaw of your character. It's their the thing that's most likely to cause their downfall in the ultimate, in the end of things. It's
a hopeless romantic.
Oh, perfect. Fit that in right now. That's beautiful.
Done.
Okay, now I will just add another one for you. this aspect I've just added for you is the origin. This is your family's, your character's family background. It's what they were born into, what they had no control over, but they were forced to deal with. I gave some
examples. He's a rich patrician's son.
Okay. So maybe I'm always tempted to go with Silver Spoon for that, but Spawn of
Silver Spoon kind of implies nobility, and I was thinking of him being part of the merchant class, technically speaking.
Hmm. Well, Spawn of the Patrician would fit there, but I want something more pithy than that. I'm sorry, my creativity apparently has gone to shit today.
I'm trying to. I know that feeling well.
Perhaps, considering silk is often considered a rich material, you could say swaddled in silk.
Oh,
that works.
So, you fill that one in? Assuming you can.
Yeah, assuming I spelled it correctly.
I don't care about spelling. I am dyslexic myself, so I will never critique people for spelling unless it's bloody stupid.
I am a grammar Nazi.
Noted.
If I may, are we supposed to be able to see other players' character sheets?
You should be able to see them. Yes.
It doesn't appear they're visible.
Okay, I will. Actually, wait a minute. Let me just check that. Check in your journal.
I shall.
It should be there.
It appears not. I can see his character name, but I cannot actually see his sheet.
That's odd. Can you go to the... You can't go to the character sheet tab at all?
No, only bio and info.
Okay. I will fix that later on. It's not essential that you see each other's character sheets anyway, and to be honest, during play, it would kind of be a disadvantage for people to be able to see each other's character sheets if you're trying to screw each other over. I mean, if you were at all planning to do anything devious.
If we come into conflict.
Exactly, which is not impossible. The next aspect we're going to be creating for you, Sasha, is going to be the youth, which is the summation of their childhood and early adolescence. Oh, actually, there's some people in the chat. I should probably just have a quick glance and make sure everything's going okay there. Hello, everybody. Hello.
Hello, viewers.
Press F to pay respects when V dies. Thanks, Trey Edge. Thank you.
I won't save my breath for that.
Right. Just wait until I actually create a character. Hold on. Somebody's put up a message. Yeah, Wolf would say hello, but he's too shy. As you can probably read on the stream right there, so I don't know why I'm pointing it out.
Neocan says, yeah, but I'm a wizard, so why would I listen to you? Very good. Wizards listen to no one.
Duly noted. Okay, so where was I? Yeah. Your next aspect is going to be your youth. So it's the summation of your childhood. Were you a bully? Were you a reader? Did they fight with other kids? Did they steal? Could they lie? Were they honest and good?
Yeah, when I was doing some brief work on the possible character, I wrote down for the youth aspect, silver-tongued socialite.
I like it. So a kid who's wined and dined his way through childhood.
Basically.
Mm-hmm. Very French. Right then. Our next one is the catalyst, which is... I describe it as the event, usually in adolescence, which crystallizes who you are as a person. It could be something life-changing, a rich kid whose family becomes destitute, a kid who is spoiled rotten, who eventually got thrown out because of their behaviour, might have found one.
Now, I wrote something for that, though it has some implications that probably aren't good for the minds of children.
I have to just pause here for a second because Bebop just said the best comment so far. His tongue is made of silver. Loot!
I wish.
Okay. So you can discuss the aspect because it's going to come up at some point in the gameplay. So.
Yeah, I wrote down, quote, Yeah, that.
Fair enough. Okay.
He's a hopeless romantic.
Okay. That's your main aspects done. You may pick up more aspects in future, and usually you'd also do aspects in relation to other members of the party, but I'm thinking of starting this group off as you guys have just met. This is the first time you've started. You've met and working together.
I like it.
That makes things a bit easier for me for writing up your early storylines. And also, since some of you are very new to role-playing, it gives you a way to be confused about things and have more flexibility in what happens. At least, that's how I feel. So, we move now on to your skills. So, if you scroll down to the skills boxes, you can see that you currently have a half pyramid of skills available to you.
Yes.
You start the game with one great skill, two good skills, three fair skills, and four average skills. All other skills, unless there are traits that change them, start at average. Start at zero, sorry, which is mediocre. So if you want to go to the skills list, which again I will put up so that people can in the chat can have a quick glance at it. Ooh. And yes, I have added one more skill since you may have last looked at it, which is herbalism, which is the ability to heal wounds out of combat, identify plants, and create things from those plants.
Yeah, so, I wrote down a few skills for my character.
Okay, if you fill them out into the box, it is worth noting, I will read out the things I actually wrote down here for myself. Be aware that if you wish to be a magic user, your highest Mancy skill will dictate how many magic stress boxes you have, and you use your magic stress boxes when you are casting spells. Jewelsmithing, interesting. Where was it again? Your physique skill will give you extra health stress boxes. You start the game with two. Your will will give you extra will stress boxes. You start the game again with two. Your reaction will affect how quickly you can respond to things happening around you. And your awareness will affect how likely you are to passively notice things. So if somebody was drawing a sword to your left, you have a certain chance of noticing that just off of your awareness skill. Whereas other people, they would, if their awareness skill wasn't high enough, they wouldn't detect it. Oh, song as well. That's an interesting combination. So we've got seduction, pole arms, jewel smithing, instrument, swordsman, reaction, archery, will, herbalism, and song. So you're going to have comparatively little health because you'll only have two health stress boxes. But you will be able to heal yourself, so you're just going to need to watch yourself in combat. Okay?
Okay.
So, if we head down to the stress boxes. Now, you've got two physical stress boxes, so I will tick off those two. Two base mental stress boxes, which would be will, but I can't edit the bloody character sheet. And you've also put one point into it, which will give you one extra stress box for mental.
Yes.
if you had put a +2 in it, it would still only give you one extra stress box. If you had put a +3 in it, it would give you a plus. It would give you 4 stress boxes. Don't ask me why it's that way around. I've never completely been comfortable with it myself.
It just works like that.
Exactly. You don't have any magical skills, so at the moment your magic skill will be 0.
Of course.
So there is no mancy skill for you. So if you were ever in a position to do magic, like you pick up a magical item, you will have no skill in using it, but it won't put you at a disadvantage. It just means that you won't be able to excuse me, you won't be able to use it with as much focus or flexibility.
Yeah, I get that.
Now let's go down to stunts. Now stunts are special skills which are unique to your character. In fact, I'll read out what I've written here, because I've actually had time to think of that and put it through that way. Stunts are specific things your character can do. You get 3 free stunts, a free racial stunt, and can spend fate points to add more stunts. Fate points are a core part of the fate system. You start the game with 6 of them, but you may choose to spend some of those on stunts during character creation. It is, however, advisable not to spend all of them, as fate points can be used to invoke aspects or use specific stunts. But this will be explained later on. For now, it is unwise to spend more than 3 of your fate points on extra stunts, but you can always rework that later if you end up unhappy with how this works out. The stunts list currently is made up of mostly example stunts. One of the features of the Fate system is that you can create your own stunts in coordination with the Game Master / Dungeon Master. As a general rule, you can copy the pattern from the stunts in the list, an advantage or ability specific to your skills, but relatively limited in scope. Magic users will probably want to take all 3 magical stunts. I won't go into detail with that because you don't have the magical abilities, so it's not relevant.
Yeah.
Here we go. I will go over the magical bit later on.
And I never actually decided on any stunts.
Okay, so let's go over the stunts list then. So what skills do you have? You have... hold on, let me scroll up. Seduction is your main... is your great skill. So let's have a look at seduction.
Yes, it is.
It helps if on the right list. Durr. Seduction. So you could choose to have honeyed words, which gives you +2 seduction when offering a bribe, which might not be the most useful thing for your character. It depends on how you want to play him. Oh.
No.
No? Okay.
Sometimes,
But as I say, you can also negotiate different stunts if you want to. You can take 3 basic stunts. You can take 3 stunts for free, and you can then add extra ones with your fate points. Now, at the beginning of each session, you get your full allowance of fate points up to however much you have left. So if you spend 3 fate points on stunts today while you're creating your character, whenever you start a session, you will start a session with 3 fate points. Even if you spent all 3 of them last session. You with me?
Mostly, yeah.
Okay. Trust me, it becomes easier to see what's going on once you're actually playing it. So for now, you only need to pick out 3 stunts. And if you wanted to, you could actually just say, I don't want any stunts, which I did with my first character and amazingly managed to make it work.
I am having a little bit of trouble grasping exactly what stunts encompass.
Okay. Stunts would be abilities, so they are specific things you can do with your skills. Well, if I go to the stunts list right now, and I scroll up to... I'll list some of them off and try and explain it from there. So, if you have a good awareness skill, it might pay to have the sharp-eyed one, which gives you an extra set of awareness out of combat, which would be useful for seeing if combat was about to start or spotting something in the distance while you're at combat. If you chose the current base default reaction one, which is lightning reflexes, you get +2 to reflex checks out of combat. So if you're in a situation where something's about to drop on you, you can jump out the way better. However, it's very specific. It isn't something that gives you a +2 all the time. It's only when you're in certain situations. For instance, the physique stunt I give as an example is strong constitution, +2 to resist consumed poison. So if somebody injected you with the poison, it wouldn't help. But if you ate something that was poisoned, you would have a better chance of avoiding being killed or injured by it. They are specific to your skills, and they give you bonuses which help you out in specific situations. For instance, will. Iron will. You may choose to take damage to your will in place of your health. Now, in the case of your character, because you have more will stress boxes than physique stress boxes, that might be useful. So you might want to put that one down, because that would allow you to, in a situation where you've just been stabbed, you could take will stress box and just say that you are using your force of will to suppress the pain.
I'll do that.
Okay, so that's one of your stunts down. Archery, longbow training. So right now, if you as a rat pick up a longbow, you are going to have some serious problems firing it, because it's massive. If you took the longbow training stunt, you would have had the training growing up to actually use that thing effectively. And you would have the same thing with the pole arms one, which is balancer. No disadvantage to using very long pole arms. So as a rat, that would be a massive advantage to you, because you'll have big problems.
I'm going to take balancer as well.
Okay. So, excuse me, do you have one more to get?
If I may, so stunts are passive. They don't have to be invoked with fate points or anything, do they?
At the moment, all of these ones are passive. Yeah, there are one or two times when I've created a stunt which uses a fate point, it's usually something which is absolutely ridiculously OP, but you can only do it like the
fade stunt on the stealth.
Yeah, so it would be something you can do once or twice, but you never want to. You don't want somebody doing it all the damn time. So if I go down to the fade stunt, you may spend a fate point to hide from a specific foe with guaranteed success. Now, in normal combat situations, that's completely freaking broken. However, because you can only hide from one specific foe, and you have to spend a fate point to do it, you can do it a maximum of 6 times in a session, which limits its power. And also, if somebody's building a stealth character, they're probably going to have to spend a couple of other fate points earlier as well to be able to make decent use of their skills. Sorry, I just saw Beavit. Bebop's question, can you start with a bad skill, something you're incompetent at but convinced you're good at, for bonus points? No, but I might actually make that into a stunt for you, Bebop. Okay, so do you want... you okay there, Sasha?
Yeah.
Are you okay, or do you just want to keep finding more stunts, because you've got one more to go?
I'm going to take Exquisite Taste.
Okay, which one was that? Oh, that was for the jewelry, the jewelsmithing. So you get an extra 1d20% more than it would normally be worth. So when you come to sell a piece of jewelry, you can roll 1d20, which you can do in roll 20 quite easily.
Of course.
And you take the percentage you get from that die to add to the value of the item. So you could get a 1, in which case you only add 1%, but you could also get a 20, in which case you add 20% to its value.
Hey, it's still more than 100%.
Exactly.
Exactly.
Thank you, myself, Fire. Echo. Right, you can choose to take more stunts if you want, but from the sounds of things, you're not quite comfortable with them yet, and so maybe you want to feel out how they work before you do so.
Yeah, I kind of want to create a stunt for my seduction skill, possibly involving attempting to... I was thinking of something intending to, like, put a foe at a disadvantage a bit due to through trying to be alluring or something due to being a hopeless romantic.
I suppose you could quote poetry at them in a romantic fashion. or you could just act incredibly lewdly toward them.
Yes.
Hey, honey, like the whiskers?
God!
I hear that the humans like and like you like tend to have a liking for the rats.
So you just make the enemy shudder themselves to death.
This snout is magical.
God.
The snout has more than just one use.
Okay, that's the name of the stunt. The snout has more than one use. You may, in combat, you can choose one of these two stunts. In combat, you can disgust one enemy into inaction for a turn per combat round. Or you can spend a fate point and have that and have that enemy just spend the rest of the combat vomiting. Which allows you to take one enemy basically out of the battle unless they keep trying to fight while vomiting.
It can disgust one enemy into inaction
for a turn. So you could keep doing it every single turn, but you would be doing that instead of attacking. So it's something you might do to specifically stop somebody from killing somebody else in the party, or stop them from killing you. You could just stun lock them so that your party members could come up and kill them for you. Now, I should probably make you roll for that.
I can spend fate point to make said enemy vomit until...
combat finishes. However, what I'm going to say is you may pick one of those for your stunt. So you can either have the can disgust an enemy into action for one turn in combat, or you may... Fair enough.
I'm going with the disgust an enemy into inaction for a combat turn.
Okay, so basically you can stun lock an enemy. But when you do that, you won't be able to actually hurt them. Unless you decide to try and take an extra turn, in which case it becomes a bit harder, because every subsequent action you take gets, I think it's a +3, but I'll need to double check that.
I understand.
Oh my god, Lothian. Oh my god, Lothian.
I'm not viewing the stream right now.
Stunt.
I regret this.
Stunt. Fur tickles in all the right places.
What have I just walked into? Do I need an adult? Do yes. I need an adult?
Yes. Yes, you need an adult.
Okay, I'll call up my dad. I'll be fine.
Can I borrow your dad for this one? Because I think I need an adult as well.
Oh my. Sure. I totally link dad. That's John, by the way.
Welcome to the stream, Ascentuous. I had actually forgotten you would be joining us today because I have the memory of a goldfish.
You have a memory of a goldfish too, like my cats?
Wow. So I will add you to the Roll 20. We are broadcasting right now, so just let me know.
Okay.
Actually, the Roll 20 should be up in the chat, if you would just scroll up a little bit.
What exactly?
I got it.
What exactly would fur tickles in all the right places?
I do not want to know.
I don't want to know either. And I like cats, so I'm scared.
Oh, no, he's playing as a rat.
Oh, okay.
So, this should be available by everybody.
Oh, I forgot to change my icon. Oops.
But we don't have a rat and
a cat in our party.
There we go. Okay, Centaurus, you should now have access to a character sheet of your very own, and we will go through that with you in a moment. I'm doing Sasha's first because they're going to have to head off at some point.
Oh, and here I ran from my chores to come here on time. I'm joking.
It's okay.
I don't run.
Well, that's all the stunts I want for now, anyway.
Okay. So you've spent one fate point. Okay.
Okay.
Now you do need to add your racial stunt, which in the case of your one was the Nightwalker one. Yes.
Yes.
Why do I have that open? I don't need that. So, rats, Nightwalker. So that is plus one to stealth, dexterity, and seduction, but minus three to diplomacy. You suck at diplomacy. Okay, let's see what's going on in the chat. Apparently, Wolf Venom informs us that goldfish can remember up to 5 months. Which, yes, actually, I believe I've heard that research myself.
And there's your useless knowledge of the day.
I wouldn't say it's useless. I mean, you could teach goldfish your password and have them remember it until they force you to change it next. Hey, Blue.
Hey, Blue.
Yeah, I'm excuse me a second. I'm creating a fate-based fantasy game. So, I think that's everything done for your character, apart from to say that your fate points are 5, which I will set up for you. So, your refresh is 5. That's how many...
Oh, hi, Mantis! Sorry, I'm just looking at chat now.
My ears. So,
yeah, the volume makes me a bit off. You might want to turn down sound slightly.
Yeah, if I... Oh, yeah, I can do that in the chat thingamabob, can't I? Hold on. Sorry, Centaurus. Nothing against you, it's just you're loud.
Yeah.
How the hell do I adjust it again?
I know. Where's get very excited.
Where's the volume control?
Adrian did it again.
Where's the volume control for individuals? Oh, it's right tip. It's right click.
Yes.
I'm going to set you down to about 75%. Could you say something, Centaurus?
Hi.
Okay, that sounds okay. Right, the only thing you've got to do left, Sasha, for now anyway, is either refine the hedonist aspect and give a name for your character, and also in the description box, give their race. Bebop, it depends on the circumstances, honestly, and the enemy, but it might do. It's very situational. And you can work on a name later on if you don't have one to hand right now.
Yeah, I don't have one right now, but I will come up with one.
If you want
random
help with
name
that,
generator?
Yeah, there is actually a good one. If you give me a second.
Hey, I can do one up.
Okay, fine. Jeez, trying to be helpful.
Yeah, I
am you my mic now.
Hi.
Hello, person.
Hello, Wolf Venom. Welcome for joining us. What the?
That was English. That was perfect English.
I can has English.
In the hood, that was perfect English.
Right. I've just put a link in the chat to the website where I actually generated the map you can see as the background right now. But they also have random name generators. You probably don't want it set to human male, but have a flip through that if you want help with name generation. Or you can speak to myself later on if you want to. I won't do it in the middle of the game creation because, well, I bore people to death. Right then, since we've completed pretty much the basics of your character sheet. Oh, equipment. I didn't think to do equipment for you. Bottoms. Well, you have a skill in good, a skill in pole arms, a skill in sword, and a skill in archery. I will let you pick up to 2 weapons. So do you want to have a polearm and maybe a bow? Or do you want to have a polearm and a sword, or a sword and a bow? What do you want?
Pole arm and a bow.
Pole arm and a bow. Okay, so we'll give you... how would you like a pike?
Pike. Those are the really long ear things that were used against cavalrymen, right?
Primarily, yeah. You could just have a spear if you want.
Yeah, I'd prefer a spear.
Okay. And I'll give you a steel tip.
Okay.
Which sounds weird, but never mind. And a standard short bow.
Yes. The spear is not the only thing steel tipped. I had to do it.
Yeah, you probably did, and you shall be punished for it appropriately.
My question is, if it's steel-tipped, how do you use it?
What do you mean?
You stick it in the bad guy?
That works. Do you want to have just clothing, or do you have to have, or would you like to have light armor? But because you don't have a light armor skill, you won't get any major bonuses to it. You'll just have a low amount of
armor. I'll just have clothing. It's just clothing.
Okay.
Fine.
Rich clothing, given your background.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm editing this to your character sheet for you because.
Yeah, I can see that.
Okay. Given that you've got a rich background, I'm probably going to give you something in the region of 50 gold.
Right,
just to start you off. I'm going to put on a quick commercial, guys, because they pay the bills.
Of course.
Those bills need to be paid.
So,
are you going to sell your Pokemon games or something?
I've never played Pokemon.
Yeah, Bill does need to get paid in order for you to keep going.
Right, so I won't do any character creation for about a minute. But yeah, we'll give you a couple of other items based on what your backgrounds are. So you've got herbalism, so I might give you a basic herbalism kit. And you've also got instruments, so I presume you'd like to have some kind of musical instrument?
A psaltery.
I have absolutely no idea what the fuck that is. I've got to be honest. Do you want to put a picture of that up in the chat and I will...
Give me a moment to do that.
Well, whilst you finish off on Sasha's and then maybe start someone else's sheet, I need to be excused for just a couple of minutes.
Go for it. Ooh, let me just grab a drink.
And by chat, do you mean the Discord, or...?
No, put it up in the Roll20 chat.
A link to a picture of a psaltery. They come in bowed and plucked varieties.
Oh. Yeah, I've seen these before, but I had no idea what they were.
Yeah, that is a bowed psaltery.
Okay. Well, if you want to add that to your character sheet, go ahead.
It looks like a portable harp.
Hmm.
That is kind of what it is, but at the same time, medieval instruments are complicated.
I know. I took music history twice.
So you don't want to take the instrument's It's Built Tough stunt, where you can use it as a +1 blunt weapon?
Why would I sully my psaltery by using it as a weapon?
Because it guarantees it won't destroy itself if you ever have to use it.
I'd rather take one of the strings off and grot someone.
Brilliant idea!
But then that costs another fate point.
Yes, I know. I'm tempting you into evil thoughts.
Well, you tried.
Yeah, I know. But yeah, for now... excuse me, I'm coughing. For now, we also wanted to give you a herbalism kit and possibly a set of jewelry assessment tools. I don't think I can give you crafting tools. You're going to need to go to Forge to be able to get access to those.
I'm sorry, what was that?
So I'm going to give you a herbalism kit, which allows you to do herbalism shit. I can't give you a full jewelry smithing thing, because that's going to include a lot of tools. So what I'm going to say is you can have an assessing kit, so you can assess the value of jewelry effectively.
Yes.
Okay, yep. That's if I use the right one. So I think that's a good set of equipment for you. We could go over and refine that at a later date. So for now, Sasha, we have got the basic outline of your character. Happy with it?
Yes.
Okay, you're a hedonist who's also a hopeless romantic who was swaddled in silk, became a silver-tongued socialite, and... I took those two to bed.
You mean a hedonist?
Yeah, I said a hedonist, didn't I?
Hedonist, hedonist.
You said hedonist.
Hedonist, hedonist.
Pronunciation. Different people pronounce words differently.
As long exactly. As you know them.
And he's a rat as well. Lovely.
6 inches. I'm reading chat.
The specific height for the rat men, if you give me a second to look at the species list, was between 3 foot and 5 foot. So do you want to put your height in under your notes? You can pick what height you want to be.
He's 4'3".
Okay, that works for me.
I thought that was a good question.
Yeah, I saw that one. And I have designed politics and economics for this world. Well, politics. The economics I haven't done massively yet. But I won't be Star Wars prequeling it yet. It's a lot more, as I said before, stabby.
Oh, no fear. Nowhere. Star Wars prequels kind of economy. Oh, terrible.
So, there we go. What colour is your fur sent to it? Sasha, why was I about to say sent to it?
It's white.
Okay, if you make a note of that in the notes, so we know for the future.
Erasers are not toys, kitty.
And notes. Yes.
Okay. And do you want to do an eye colour? I'll leave it open to you what you want to do there.
Eye colours.
They tend towards red.
I'm guessing it's a matter of just how red then.
Well,
I decided on burgundy.
Fair enough. Okay, I think that's your character done then, apart from the name. But we can get back to that later.
Yeah, I'll come up with one at some point.
That's fine. I will close this character sheet now. And who would like to go next?
Roll a d20 or something? I don't know.
Well, it wouldn't be a d20 because there's only three of you. But I can roll a d3.
One, there you two, go.
Three.
Problem solved.
Well, okay, d6 divided by two.
There's a d.
Three. One, two, three. Centaurus, you're up.
Okay. Great.
The person who missed all the bump earlier on has to do it next. Yay!
Yep! Yeah!
So I'll go over the bump again then. Okay, let's start with the... do you know what species you want to be yet?
Cat.
Cat species? Okay, have you... okay, so if you, in the description, make a note that it's going to be feline. Should have it. Yeah, you got it. Your high concept aspect is the core attributes of your character. You did read through the list I gave, the sheet I gave earlier for creating a character, didn't you?
The race sheet, or
no? I did a sheet later on, which was just describing character creation. If you haven't, don't worry. I've got it up here, and I can read it out.
Got it.
Okay. It's fairly long, so it'd probably be easier to just talk you through it, honestly, if you haven't had a chance to see it.
Yeah.
That's fair enough. Okay, your high concept is the core attribute, is the core focus of your character. It's who they are at heart. When push comes to shove, who are they? What do they do? Do they go back and save people? Do they save themselves? Do they focus purely on money? Are they a coward?
Those are all the options.
Well, no, there's a whole host. You can be whatever you want to be, or whatever your character is. Now, the felines tend to be prideful, so if that gives you any inspiration.
I got nothing.
Okay, well, let me give you a description of the felines. Arrogant and prideful, the cats vary from brutish lions and tigerkin to clever wildcats and similar. They are massively varied in size and temperament, though few would be described as humble. They occupy lands west of the kings. They rarely live beyond their 80s, most choosing to face their mortality in wine, lovers, and rich food. And I have a map of the area where they come from. They come from the area around about here. The Kings being a big mountain range to the east of where you guys are going to be based out of, the Principality of Telferin.
Why, yes, Bebop the First. It is, in fact, a joke. Why are you not laughing?
It's the best joke.
It's a stereotype. The best kind of way of creating characters. Oh, God.
I have returned. Hello.
Welcome back. We've just started on doing Centaurus' character.
Yes, I was following on the stream.
Okay, so, what about traitor? We have traitors? Do we have any traitors?
Yep,
I know someone wants to be a diplomat, so...
Hello.
We can go a trade, that works for me.
Yeah. A traitor that's very good at stealing money and stabbing people.
So,
because the deals go wrong, you know. So you gotta be quick.
So make more of a rogue trader.
Yeah,
I think that should be your high concept.
That you sell your stolen goods to.
Oh, so what they call a fence? That's it.
Yeah, it's called a fence.
How about cat on the fence?
Yeah, I'll be the cat on the fence, totally.
Or cat on the wall when Trump is there.
No political discussions in this stream.
Oh god, glad you're not lying about that. Oh, Bebop. So if you type that up in your high concept aspect. I mean, I can type it up if you want.
Sure, thanks.
Of course, you're now relying on my spelling.
My spelling is probably worse, so I blame the New York City school system.
I went through a fairly large chunk of my life spelling water with two R's. Dyslexia is a fun thing to deal with.
Okay. I guess I'll have to do this myself.
Okay, trouble aspect. This is your character's fatal flaw. It's what's likely to bring them down in the end. It's their problem. I gave some examples here. So with the high concept, actually, I'm going to read out what I wrote because this is fucking funny. Or at least it is to me because I'm weird.
Do you realize who you're talking to? We're all weird. Okay.
Yeah, true.
I'm not weird. He is not.
This is
you are talking about a party member who made a seductive rat.
True, he did. Right. For example, a man who has fought to defend his honour might have the high concept death before dishonour. Somebody who values wealth over everything else might be in it for the coin. Or a woman who secretly works to overthrow the bourgeois elite and establish a socialist utopia might be making her marks. Yes, that joke is terrible, I know. High concept can be a serious point about the character or an amusing way of explaining who they are. Just make sure it describes who they are. Once you have a high concept, let's move on to the trouble aspect. This one is fairly self-explanatory. It's your character's potential downfall. What element of their personality has the potential to cause them problems? For example, a man with death before dishonor might be cursed with the addiction that makes his dishonor all the more likely. He might be a drunkard or a womanizer or even forgetful. Any one of those has the potential to destroy him. A character in it for the coin might be a compulsive gambler or even have trouble that's not directly related to their high concept. They might have fear of horses or have a sensory issue such as death. As for a character who is making her marks, she may be cursed with decadent, meaning she's always tempted to indulge in luxury and vice despite
her high concept. Decadence works.
So you're decadent. Okay. Do you want me to put that down for you, or are you going to put that
down? Yeah, that's fine.
Sorry, I'm coughing. And now I've probably spelt it the wrong way. Okay.
It doesn't matter. I get it. I know what you mean.
So, the next aspect you're going to be doing is... the next few aspects cover your life stages. Your origin is simply your character's family background. Were they born poor in a far-off toxy? Are they a scion of a rich local family? Are they an orc woodcutter? An orc blessed. Blessed with magical powers by their gods, a child of an elven woodcutter, a second son of a dwarven merchant. The options are endless. But you boil them down into a simple aspect. Born poor in Toxie and street rat, scion of a rich local family, silver spoon, an orc blessed with suck. The child of an elven woodcutter might be humble woodsman. You get the idea. It's what your character was born into.
The silver spoon works. It's silver spoon, right? I heard silver. Okay. You said that really fast.
Sorry, I'm losing my voice a bit. A silver spoon would be somebody who is born into a rich family background. Does that fit with your character?
Small snobs.
No. They small could snobs, be rich by being criminals.
Okay.
They're criminal, basically smugglers that became rich enough for the rich people to go like, oh, we're going to ignore the fact that you're smugglers. And then it's just like, sure, we'll smuggle all of your stolen... A fancy person is like, I want this illegal thing. Who do I talk to?
So them. Basically, new criminal rich.
Yeah.
Yeah, mafia. Legitimate businessmen.
Yeah.
Exactly.
In fact, I like that. Legitimate businessmen. I like
exactly.
that.
Exactly.
You're welcome.
Okay, the next aspect is going to be your youth. It's the summation of your childhood. Were you a bully? Were you a reader? Did you fight with other kids? Did you steal? Could you lie? Or were you honest and good? A kid who was thoughtful and dutiful might be wise beyond years. One who picked fights and bullied might simply be a bullying bruiser. One who had a talent for singing could have been voice of an angel. One who was good at thievery might be always hunted, never caught.
I'll go for stealing.
Well, that would fit with your character. So what do you want to be? Do you want to have always been able to get stuff, or could always find what you wanted, or were caught for stealing?
I can always find what I want.
Okay, so I have my sources.
Yep. Yeah, that works.
Okay. The final aspect you need to create for this is the catalyst. It's the event, usually in adolescence, which crystallizes who they are as a person. It could be something life-changing, a rich kid whose family become destitute, where did the money go? Or perhaps a kid who was spoiled rotten, eventually getting thrown out for their behaviour, thrown to the peasants. Or they might have come across wealth, a rich find. Or they may have had something terrible happen, my family murdered. Or done something terrible, my family murdered, at last.
I'll take the first, my family was murdered. Not the second one, the first one.
Okay, so they're all dead.
Yep.
So was it by other legitimate businessmen?
Exactly.
Trying to get
the
their
legitimate businessmen had their past catch up to them.
That exactly. Sounds good. We should make a note of that for later. Okay then, now we go on to your skills. Now you've seen the skills list already, yep?
I maybe glanced at it and then I kind of forgot because I had to...
Go open the skills list.
People. Yes, Dad, okay.
Don't call me Dad.
Yeah, yes, you're right, Mom. John's the only Dad. Yeah, Mom, exactly, Mom works.
Mom!
Yeah.
Now, Mom honey.
Let's see. Stunts less skills. Okay, got it. I got skills.
Okay. I mean, GF, and that stands for good mother, right?
Yes. Like, wow. You know, Molly Weasley. That works. That works. Exactly. He's our Molly Weasley.
Wow. Okay. You.
Start... I don't. Can our jumper be purple?
Sorry?
Yeah, when you mail everyone our jumpers, can mine be purple?
What jumpers? What?
Yeah, Molly Weasley sends people jumpers for the holidays.
I have no
idea. You didn't read Harry Potter, did you?
No.
You failed at nerdness. You failed at it. You failed. You failed.
Yeah, because I auditioned for the role and didn't get it.
Did you?
Yeah. And then they picked somebody who didn't audition. They just spotted him in the theater. I was like, rage!
Oh, well.
Anyway.
Well, that just happens.
Yeah. Anyway, so you start the game with 1+4 skill, which is a great skill. 2+3 skills, which are good skills. 3+2 skills, which are fair skills, and 4+4 skills, which are average skills. All other skills, unless modified by something else, start off as 0.
Okay.
So, and it's worth bearing in mind that there are some skills which give you useful stuff. Like, if you want to use magic at all, your highest Mancy skill will dictate how many magic stress boxes you have. And you can expend magic stress boxes to make a spell better. So if to do magic in this game, you roll your d4. You tell me what effect you want to have. You roll a d4. You roll 4d... Oh, God's sake, Ian, get your brain together. Okay, you roll 4d6.
Mm-hmm.
Each d6 will give you a number, which translates into either a minus, a zero, or a plus.
Okay.
So if you get 1 or 2, that's a minus. If you get 3 or 4, that's a zero. If you get 5 or 6, that's a plus. I will tell you how high of a roll you need to make for that magic effect to happen. And you can either burn magical stress boxes to reach that number, or you can spend fate points, or you can just roll high enough to do it. Most magical effects will require a 1 or a 2, which on a dice roll, yeah, that's fine. And your skill in magic will usually give you enough of a bonus that you'll be able to get over that. But if you want to do something extreme, like bring somebody back from the dead, yeah, you're going to need a good roll for that on top of a very good skill.
Okay, can I just be really good at hiding and stabbing people?
Okay, so you want to have a good stealth skill and maybe a good swordsman skill?
Actually, I was thinking like, so here's what I was thinking. Like, stealth is like the main one, right? Okay. And then secondary would be like unarmed, and then after that would be like crossbows.
Okay, so do you want to have crossbows as a +3 skill or a +2 skill?
+2 skill.
Okay. Excuse me. Your physique skill will dictate how much stress, how many health stress boxes you have. You start the game with 2. If you add one point or two points, you get an extra stress box. If you add 3 points or 4 points, you will get two extra stress boxes, so you can take more damage.
I'll take more damage. That'd be cool.
How high do you want that? Do you want just one stress box or two?
Two.
Okay. Physique. Now, your will dictate your ability to resist being coerced and a few other bits and bobs. You can also, if you take certain stunts, use it as extra health, in effect, which is what Ratman is going to be doing. Ratman! Ratman! Okay, I'll stop. Sorry. So, if you want to have a bonus to that, you can add that as a plus one, maybe?
Yeah, a plus one is fine.
Okay. Your reaction will dictate how quickly you react to things, so that will be basically your order in combat and your ability to dodge out the way of falling rocks, say. Okay. So I'd recommend you put at least a plus one in that, maybe a plus two.
That's fine.
Plus one or two?
Two.
Okay. Your awareness skill dictates how passively aware you are about of things around you. So if somebody's drawing a sword, if your passive awareness is high enough, you'll see it straight away. It will also allow you to notice details and stuff around you. I recommend that you have that. A one in that is a good thing, but you don't need to.
Yeah, a one in that's fine.
Okay. So, let's have a look at what other skills we've got available. Dexterity would be a useful one for you as well. That will be your ability to stick landings. It's your poise in combat and out of combat. And what just happened to my page? Oh, somebody's renamed their one. Excellent.
Oh, yeah, it's me.
Nice.
I renamed it. Yeah. I should put that in parentheses. That's then.
Wait, there you go.
Poise, the Dark Souls.
If you put your character name in the ID block, that would help, but for the moment, that's fine.
Okay.
So, what are the ones? So dexterity is a good one for you. It will also help you if you're trying to do a physical task where you need to be careful about something, like, let's say, walking over a tightrope. It would be a good fit for a kitty.
It would be a good fit for a cat.
Plus two?
Yeah.
Dexterity. Okay, let's have a look at other skills we've got. So do you want any magical skill at all?
Nope.
Okay. Do you want diplomacy, intimidation, seduction? Diplomacy.
We already have a Diplo character, right?
Yeah. Or we will do.
So I could be the intimidation? But I'm a cat, so I have negative, was it? Is it negative two to the intimidation anyway?
Yeah, we also have a great big great big Drake who is going to basically be the intimidation monster.
Oh, okay.
Yes, we appear to have all forms of compelling. Somebody found it. We have the disgust seduction.
Mm-hmm.
We have diplomacy, which I will be taking over, and we have big scary smashy Drake.
Okay.
You could go for traps, looting.
Yeah, traps and looting. That's fine.
Okay, I'll put those as your remaining plus ones, and I'll spill my drink all over myself because I'm a prat.
Good job. Good job.
So if you want to find stuff when you go into a dungeon or something, send her in first when looking at the chests and that, because she'll be able to actually find stuff for you.
Send the cat in first, guys.
Kitty! Right, physical stress boxes. You start the game with two.
Okay.
Excuse me. And because you've got physique at plus three, you get an extra two, so you are quite tanky.
Oh, and really?
You start the game with two mental stress boxes, but you've got a plus one to that, so you've got a third one. You don't have any magical ones, but I'll put magic for down and you don't have a governing skill because you don't have any magical skill. But if you pick up a magical item, you will be rolling it effectively at a zero. So.
That's fine. Who's the magic user? Oh, do we have a magic user?
We don't have a magic user yet, so this will be interesting.
I shall be taking magic, actually.
Okay. Okay, got it. I devised this entire magical system and nobody uses it. I love it. Well done, guys.
I'm going to take two sets.
Oh, interesting.
See, what happened was, I always forgot to use my magic, so that's why I'm just like, let me not use my magic.
Okay. So I'll put down armor as well, but we'll get to that later on. So that's your...
Oh yeah, do I have armor? How much armor can I carry?
We'll get to that later. You don't. Okay. You haven't taken any armor skills, so you, if you wear armor, you will have disadvantages. So if you wear armor and you don't have an armor skill, you're going to make a lot of noise, and it won't be as effective.
Okay.
So
increased physique might counteract that, though.
Yeah, you've got a shit ton of health.
Yeah. Okay, basically what I'm saying is, could I wear like an Assassin's Creed style like cloak and blue billowy clothes and stuff?
We can do that when we get to the extra the equipment and stuff. Right now I'm going to go through stunts for you. But yeah, I don't see anything wrong with you having billowy cloaky shit.
Hoods and cloaks, kids, they're the best.
Except when you're trying to climb something, as opposed to just get snagged and then you'll fall to death.
Yeah, that would probably not be the best thing to wear when you.
Or it gets caught into a giant fan and I get chopped to pieces.
Yeah,
indeed.
I better make
detachable
notes.
Cape for the win.
Don't give the GM ideas.
Detachable cape. I've solved the problem.
Detachable cape. So it's got little magnetic clasps. You've got little hematite clasps on it.
Basically.
Okay.
Just tug on one of the ropes and it just goes.
So let's start on your stunts. Stunts. Okay. Let me actually look at my own fucking notes here. Pardon my French. There it is. Right. Stunts are specific things your character can do. You get three free stunts, a free racial stunt, and can spend fate points to add more stunts. Fate points are a core part of the fate system. You start the game with six of them, but you may choose to spend some of them on stunts during the character creation. It is, however, advisable not to spend all of them, as they can, as fate points are used to invoke aspects or use specific stunts. But this will be explained later on. For now, know that it's unwise to spend more than three of your fate points on extra stunts, but you can always rework that later if you end up unhappy with how it works out. The stunts list is currently made up of example stunts. One of the features of the Fate system is that you can create your own stunts in coordination with the Game Master / Dungeon Master. As a general rule, you can copy the pattern of the stunts given in the list, an advantage or ability specific to your skills, but relatively limited in scope.
Okay.
You with me?
Yeah, I got it.
Since you're not a magical user, I won't read the rest of the bump, because it's not relevant to you.
Mm-hmm.
But since you're a stealth character, you might want to take a look at the stealth stunt I gave as an example. Fade may spend a fate point to hide from a specific foe with guaranteed success.
Stealth. However, skills. That means you might want to limit how many stunts you take to increase your quantity of...
Stealth and lockpicking.
You don't have a lockpicking skill, but it would allow you to do stuff.
It's on the list. It says stealth skill stunts.
Yeah, but you don't have...
And the render is lockpick. You don't have a lockpick
skill specifically, so you'll be going from a zero, but it might give you a bonus enough that would be worth taking, so...
Never mind, then.
Excuse me. Stunts are generally best to use in coordination with your skills you've got, but they can be used to compensate for a lack of skill in something.
Mm-hmm.
And you've got to pick at least three.
Okay. So, we already have the stealth. So, I was going to go with unarmed.
Okay, so you want fade. I will copy and paste it over, actually, rather than trying to type it out from memory. Because otherwise I will forget, because I have the memory of a goldfish. Okay, and you wanted the unarmed stunt, which was...
What
was
the artist.
Oh, yes, so you can basically... You can beat up on somebody and not injure yourself in the process.
Yeah, I see. That sounds like done.
Okay. Because there's a risk if you do a bad roll that you'll injure yourself. With a martial artist, you don't injure yourself.
Exactly.
Okay, so one more stunt. Let's go look at the right list. You might want to go... Well, actually, no, ballista training wouldn't be particularly useful because ballistas are the sort of things you'd mount on... Yeah, they're the sort of things you'd mount on a castle for defense or use to attack a castle.
Yeah, I know what ballistas are.
Okay, but if you ever want to go...
I watch the History Channel.
If you ever want to go dragon hunting, you might want to pick that up at some later date.
Yeah, just hire some, like, you know, some oxen, slap some ballistas on it. Boom, problem solved.
Wow.
What? No one ever thought of that.
It appears we're going to have some conflicts. Not only do we have a cat and a rat, we apparently also have the cat who wants to kill the dragon.
Yeah. I might not like that, considering
that's already in the world right here.
Hey, I'm just saying, I just told you, best idea, just hire some, like, you know, beasts of burden, slap ballistas on them, kill dragons, problem solved.
Just for reference, dragons in this world are not necessarily evil or destroying everything. Some of them are actually fairly decent people. They I mean, they eat people, but yeah, you know, yeah. They're pretty decent otherwise.
Oh.
Don't say sorry on the plague about it, that's fine.
I have a question.
Go for it.
So, you know, it'd be cool if one of my characters, like, fence contacts was a dragon.
I will let you take that as a stunt.
Fine.
Okay.
I'm friends with a dragon. I win.
If I'm not wrong, the drakes are anthropomorphic, yes?
Yes, they are.
Can I name my dragon friend?
No, that's up to him. Or her.
His name is Bob.
I can give you... I can give you a name that'll work for any gender.
So I can give you the stunt. I know a dragon. May spend a fate point to call in the dragon associate.
Totally. It's only for emergencies, guys. Like, if we find something really awesome.
Yes, it does occur to me that you are not going to want to make too many more stunts because you have a lot of fate point costs on your current stunts.
No, I'll doesn't. Be fine.
She
I'm
has
good.
Three. She has three free stunts. Oh, you mean that she has to spend a lot of fate points on it? Yeah, that's fair. Yeah, she does. Fate. There we go. You can take. Sorry, what was that?
Nothing.
Okay. You can take an extra couple of stunts if you want to, or we can move on to your racial stunt.
I'll go to my racial stunt. I'll be fine.
Okay, so let's go to the species list, and we go to felines. You have the choice of either lion's pride, plus two physique. Oh my god, you would be fucking broken with that.
Tanky as hell.
Minus two diplomacy, free but GM compel at mirrors. So basically, every time you go past a mirror, I'm going to make you stare at it. For hours.
Here's okay. So I made a bard in D20, right? Dragon Dungeons and Dragons 5th edition. I made a bard. Mm-hmm. And her fatal flaw was like pretty things. Oh, and then we were fighting a demon that was like part succubus and she failed her role. So she spent the first turn just going like, he's so pretty. It's like, sorry guys, he's very pretty. So he's pretty?
Your alternative is Ocelot's Wiles, which gives you plus two reaction and minus two intimidation.
I'll be the lion.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, super really. Tank. We need the tank.
Okay. I like that. Like when my character's like, you know, I enjoy the fact that if, you know, she runs into something pretty, it's just like, oh my god, I have to roll against being a drooling idiot for a turn.
I kind of love the fact that this basically means we have an incredibly bulky cat sneaking around on tight ropes above everyone.
That may or may not be distracted from mirrors and may or may not miss important things because they're just going, I'm so pretty.
Yeah. This is going to go wonderfully.
The distractions of the cat will be occurring alongside the rat possibly attempting to seduce him.
I mean, it does occur to me, I do believe there is something of a seafaring culture in this world, yes? And that basically means that we're going to be surrounded by water, which is a reflective surface.
somebody's thinking ahead. By the way, guys, if you can't see what I've just written on Centaurus's character sheet, you need to see it.
I'm watching the stream.
Okay,
I actually can't see. I'm watching the stream right now, but I can't see it. It's like a two.
Oh, God, what have I done? Oh, God.
Let's see. No, that's not it.
She has boxes. She's a freaking boss level character.
Seriously, you have so much health that I will have difficulty killing you without bringing out bullshit enemies. Just letting you know. So if anybody
make,
else...
like, ridiculously bullshit traps, you know? Like, say, like, okay, my character steals from, like, fancy frou-frou people, right? Say fancy they use their fancy money to buy ridiculous traps, right? And wow. She fails the trap rolls. That's an excuse to, like, oh, but yeah. This trap is, like, an acid bomb, and you failed, so here's some acid to your face.
Hey, I hear you like acid, so I put some acid in your acid.
You know, or you could just dangle a ball of yarn.
Oh my god, oh,
yeah!
Yeah,
make that a thing too. Yarn. All yarn, and all ribbons, and all shiny things.
Okay.
That, you know, like knickknacks.
Okay, I am going to give you GM compels on that, so yep, I am totally doing that now. Okay, so... Wow.
Just append that onto the Lion's Pride racial stunt. Just say free GM compel at mirrors and yarn.
Okay, so extras. This will be your equipment. So we'll go through the basic stuff first of all. So your skill is in unarmed and crossbows. So you're going to want a decent crossbow, aren't you?
Yeah.
Well, since you're only going to have the one weapon, I'll give you a good crossbow. And to go with that, you will have... What's a good number of bolts? I'll start you out with 30 bolts. And they'll be standard bolts. You won't get a choice of armor piercing or blunt bolts, which are good for armor. You'll just have the default ones. But then early in the game, you're not going to be facing enemies who have advanced stuff. So now clothing. You want to have the Assassin's Creed flowy thingy, mibobs, whatchamacallit.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, so...
You want the flowy stuff rather than like Dark Brotherhood style, you know.
Yeah, I thought that looked kind of stupid. So what? I figure it's going to be purple.
Deep purple?
Because why not? Yeah, exactly. Like, you know, like it's so dark purple, it looks kind of black, but then when it's in certain light, you see it's purple. But when it's, you're like out of like, say, direct sunlight, it looks black. That type of dark.
Okay. Iridescent.
Since you're a thief, I'm going to be a... you're a thief whose family is all dead. I'm going to be a complete dick and not give you any money because you can just steal it.
All right, I have no money, guy.
You don't have any instrument skills, so I won't give you an enemy.
Couldn't my enemy be the person that killed my family?
You can do. I said an instrument, not an enemy.
Oh.
So you don't have that. You do have traps as a skill, so I can give you a trap, hunting trap.
Okay, sure.
So that will allow you to trap animals while you're out in the wild, if you want to. And you also have a looting skill, so maybe I'll give you maybe a pry bar for opening boxes. Actually, no, I'll give you thief tools.
Yeah.
Because that fits. If I'm in the right bloody box.
Is the chat saying that they like our voices?
They're saying they like Yahtzee's voice and apparently my voice, which is disturbing.
Indeed.
He gives good scary madness as the description of my voice. Okay.
Yeah.
So thief's tools will give you basic lockpick.
Mm-hmm.
So that is quite a high chance it will break. Pry bar. And... yeah, I'll leave it at that.
Okay, I have a question.
Go for it.
Since my character just basically like knows like how mafia works and stuff like that, right?
Yeah.
So could you say that she has like a general understanding of like criminal like world and stuff? Well, so for example,
that's the thing. Because of the way the fate system works, if you're ever put up in a position where you need to do a role to find out something about criminal bosses or something, you can tag your aspect of legitimate businessman to spend a fate point to make your role +2 better.
Okay.
And you also have, I have my sources, which refers to, you know, a whole bunch of fences and so forth, which means that you can find whatever you want. Well, not fight whatever you want, but...
I know a fence, it goes around my garden.
Sorry, what was that?
I said, I know a fence as well. It goes around my garden.
Oh, God.
I had to play that back in my brain about 3 times.
Yeah, my brain did not work with that either. So your fate points are going to be 6, because you haven't spent any, I don't think. Nope, you haven't. So, notes. Can you give me a height for your character? Because felines need to be between...
They massively vary
the size and temperament you have. Yeah, they can be whatever size you want to be.
So, yeah, I was about to say, like, what's the max, like, height?
Well, let's put it like this. You're going to be shorter than a drake, and drake's maximum height is 8 foot. I'm going to say your max is going to be 7 foot.
I just thought if we had, like, a... I mean,
that actually seems a bit too tall.
Like a 10-foot can I be tall, like... massively built cat.
I am stealthy cat, yes.
I was going to go for like 5.
Okay,
just... you know, if she's smaller, she can go through like windows and doors more easily.
So 5 foot dead?
Yeah.
Okay, 5 foot dead. What colour fur do you have?
Say purple, let's see. You know you want to.
I changed my icon, so that'll probably work. If you reload the page.
Yeah, I'd need to reload the page, and I can't do that while I'm editing stuff, so...
It's a smoky grey and white.
Actually, it's like a dark brownish and white.
Oh, I can't tell from the image.
So a patterned dark brown and white.
Yeah. Oh, then my cat's working.
And eye colour?
Can cat's eyes be purple?
Well, this is a world in which magic has fucked a whole bunch of stuff over, genetically speaking, so if you want to have purple eyes, I'll let you have it, but you will have consequences.
Those will be... being like what?
Explored later.
What? Is it kind of like the equivalent of like the social... like, you know, like when there's like albino animals, the other animals are like, oh, you're weird, reject you.
Yeah, you're going to have a certain amount of that, but it's also there are cults who may be looking for people with that kind of thing, possibly.
They're the ones that killed my family! They will pay!
I thought you said it was another business. Or legitimate business.
They could be a legitimate business, okay? Have you seen Scientology? Best
wow.
mafia ever.
It's true, but anyway, moving on. Probably shouldn't get into the politics of Scientology because it's insane. Anyway, moving on.
It gives me a headache, and I study politics.
Yeah. So, yeah, purple eyes then.
Yep, thank you.
No problem. And that's pretty much your character done. You just need to put your name up in the ID slot, and otherwise, I think you're good.
There you go, cat. Oh, okay. My cat wants to leave my room.
Right then. Who wants to go next?
ID slot. Go.
I volunteer as tribute.
Which one was that, sorry?
Ronald.
Ronald, sorry. My brain, it's no work. So, let's go to... cough all over the microphone. let's go to Ronald's character sheet. Now, what character, what species did you want to be?
I was going to go with a Humerian, so I am human.
Okay. Humian, I think I called them. Let me just double check.
I have no idea how to...
Don't worry, I pulled Hermian, that's it. Hermians, average tall men and women from the lands north of Tal Therin and west of Toxie, their dark skin mirroring that of the old Empire's people. They also claim to be the Empire's inheritors. Their lands are agriculturally rich, but they are divided from Tal Therin by the Sea of Drakes. Only rare travellers from Toxie or long trade caravans going to the west of the Kings reach Tal Therin. Have the choice of either Caravaneer, plus 2 diplomacy, minus 2 stealth, or Explorer, plus 2 physique, minus 2 seduction.
I will be going with Caravaneer.
Okay, so if you put in your description your race, so... I've already forgotten how to pronounce the thing, and I wrote the damn shit.
Happens to me all the time.
Yeah.
I just go, how do I pronounce that? I don't know.
Just to check, you are writing that in your character. Oh, there we go. And your high concept, you are already aware of what the high concept is, so let's discuss what you want to do with him. He's a trader.
Well, yeah, he's going to be a trader slash sort of diplomat. He is the sort of negotiator for his...
Okay, hold on. So I just sent a message.
Sam will just BLB.
I didn't want to, like, you know.
Okay.
Be all like, hey, guys, you know, because you're doing your thing, so.
That's fine. So if you want to be, like, an envoy, or why are you a diplomat? Are you a diplomat for your people? Are you a diplomat
I was going to be, yes, I was going to say almost an envoy of the court. Almost.
Oh, an envoy of the court. Okay, so, that's a lot of interesting things to do there. So. Are you a good person? Are you corrupt? Are you...
Very strong moral principles.
Okay, so envoy of the court. And your trouble aspect, any thought on that?
I was going to go with something like, whilst he is a very good diplomat, he's not exactly strong in combat. So I was going to say almost sharp tongue, blunt blade.
I like that. Go for it. Okay, and your next aspect will be your origin. So that's your family background, basically.
Probably, I don't know how to put it as an aspect, but I'll be a child of a court scholar.
Okay, so born into learning. Born in the library? Mm.
Perhaps a learned aristocracy?
That could work, yeah. So basically in combat, we're just going to ask Kitty to stand in front of you so that you don't get killed.
Yeah, just have the cat standing in front of me whilst I try and talk people down and the big scary drake behind me.
And the rat just makes them vomit everywhere.
Yes, the general idea.
Well, this is cringe, mostly.
Cringe. Oh god, no. So your next aspect is
going to reload the stream.
Oh yeah. Hold on. Let me just check it is okay. Hold on. Just hold up a minute, guys. Nope, it's still up here. Okay, that's odd. Okay, it was still broadcasting. It's still broadcasting for me, and it's actually playing here, so I've just asked everybody to reload their pages so that they'll be back with us.
Yeah,
I thought something wrong, because you were going through all the aspects and saying added. Okay, that's done, and I couldn't see anything being added. It was still just totally blank thing.
It takes a little bit for it to take effect,
And yeah, and also, the stream delay is going to be a factor as well. Okay, so so we're back. Your next attribute aspect is your thing in the bottom, youth. So that is how you grew up.
I will go for, I think the name for it, I was going to go for, a studious in solitude.
Okay, so yeah. You were very attentive to your books. You were very focused on learning that way. You kept away from other people.
Yes.
Okay. I can go with that.
And Catalyst, I believe, was next, yes?
That's correct, yep.
I was thinking, for want of a stronger word, it would be like a conflict resolved. It would like essentially be having perhaps a family dispute, mm-hmm. or a court dispute. Which,
well, you could have resolved something in the court which made you a peacemaker, but at the same time made you slightly awkward to have around, because there was this big problem that it's just been solved by this kid who's been around all this time.
An upstart, yeah.
Yeah, let's just shove him out of the court and let him learn what the world is actually like.
So, almost like I have rivals in the court.
Ooh. Ah. Plotting rivals, court intrigue.
Oh, yes.
Betrayed by court intrigue, right fit. And after that, we move on to your skills.
Yes, indeed.
So, you've got the skill lists up there, right?
Yes, I do.
So you probably want to have diplomacy as your big one, I'm guessing?
Actually, because of the stunt that I'm going with, I don't actually need it as my +4. I'm going to take it as a +3.
Okay.
Through my studies, I studied magic.
Okay.
And hence my +4 is going to be psychomancy.
Brain fuckery. Yes.
I'm afraid.
Probably wise, because with a +4 and with your will skill, there's a very good chance he'll be able to fuck with your head if he wants to.
I'm going to. So, my +4 is going to be psychomancy.
Okay.
My +3 shall be, firstly, diplomacy.
Okay, that's a good one.
And that, as I said earlier, I'm going to be a student of two schools of magic. And as my second school of magic, I'm going to take a +3 in biomancy.
Aha, uh-huh, so we have a healer.
As I said earlier, being a sharp tongue, blunt blade, healing has always suited my character better.
Makes sense to me.
Although I get the feeling I'm going to get compelled a lot in combat for that.
Yeah, because biomancy is the only way you're going to be able to heal somebody in combat. Herbalism, you can't just rub a herb on something and instantly be back up on your feet. But with biomancy, you can literally regrow flesh. So,
yes. That's also part of the point where I'm going to severely cap myself in fate points early with the stunt setup I'm undertaking.
Okay.
I'm just going to be posing. Because I noticed there is, in fact, 4 magical stunts.
Yes. I think. I can't actually remember off the top of my
head. Create, destroy, move, and change.
Yeah. Hold on. Let me just have a look at my stunts list here. Yes, that's correct. Because
yeah,
it's designed so that you can take at least 3 of them for free, but you'll have to spend more if you want to have full mastery.
Yes. Hence why I'm going to, in the end, I'm actually going to end up taking all 4 as well as 2 others. So I'm going to be capping myself to 3 fate points.
That's fine. Right then. So what's your other skills going to be?
That's where my next step comes in. I'm actually going to, first of all, take the sketch.
Sketch, that's a good one.
Wait, so you're going to be good at drawing?
Yep. So I'll give you some drawing supplies.
Exclusively for and doing almost exclusively for the stunt, which is the photographic memory, which quite suits the studious character.
So you'll be able to actually remember something you've seen enough to be able to draw it accurately.
Yes, like a map, for example.
Yep. Or
to help the thief steal things.
Or perhaps a magical ritual of some sort.
Mm-hmm. I'm just saying, if you help me steal things, we can all become rich together.
And she knows a dragon.
And I know a dragon.
But once again, I am an envoy of the court who is bound by my morals. How would I approve of this stealing behaviour?
Oh, you have morals?
Excellent.
Oh, how passe.
Yes, I know exactly how the GM is thinking. I'm going to get propelled to hell by this, I know.
Yep, I won't even lie. That's what's going to happen.
On the bright side, this might get me some of my fate points back.
On the plus side, though, does that mean that... So do our characters have, like morality? So, like, do I have to pick one or something?
No, you do not. There is no morality system. It's all down to how you play the character.
Okay.
And if I feel you're playing the character true to how you've played them before, I may give you bonuses. Aware this is a good one, yeah.
Okay. I just put like a D&D morality thing just to remind myself, basically.
That's fair. So your will skill is going to give you 3 stress boxes. Your magical will be 4 because you've got the absolute max. Reaction is a good one. You've taken 3 schools. Interesting.
Once again, very studious. Perhaps this court scholar who was my father was in fact a court wizard.
Yeah, that could fit.
And I'm thinking the final two should be...
Pheromancy! You could make everything smell of farts!
I did think that was a rather curious school of magic.
Well, think about it this way. What happens if you put something that stinks to high heaven straight in your enemy's nose at the start of combat?
Have you forgotten about my nose? I will probably not be pleased.
Yeah, you would just be flat out incapacitated as a feline.
Like, I don't need to do that. We already have the rat to make people vomit.
I took the can disgust one enemy into inaction for a combat turn. Rather than make them vomit.
Wow.
Can I put the morality note in the extras character?
Yeah, you can put put it in your notes rather than extras.
Okay.
Because I'm using extras more for equipment, to be honest.
Yeah, I got it.
Unfortunately, with the 3 account, I can't modify the character list to be more suitable. So.
I'm kind of wondering whether to take another school of magic as a plus one.
You can do if you want. I mean, we do have... In fact, I'll bring up the list of them. If I can find it. Where'd I put the bloody skill list? There it is. You have pyromancy, which is control of fire. Cryomancy, control of ice. Terramancy, control of earth or soil or dirt. And I've invited John to join us if he wants to see what's going on. Hold on, I'll actually put a note.
You mean Dad's going to come visit? It's going to be awesome.
You do realise he can probably hear what you're saying right now.
I've called him Dad before.
Oh, there's also chronomancy if you want to fuck with time.
Ooh, time fucker.
I took that as my plus 2 and swapped it with sketch.
Really? Interesting. Okay. But yeah, chronomancy in this, most of the time you'll be de-aging or aging a specific object. Hi, John. Welcome to the
madness. Hey, everybody.
Hi.
Hi. Just wanted to drop in, say hello. Nice to see you got things rolling.
Things are working so far.
Cool. Yep. I'd just like to thank V for for doing this. I'm really
no problem.
Both I'm glad that we can have some sort of event for thing for viewers, and also just because people have been interested in having some sort of like tabletop game stuff on the stream for a while. Now we finally can, and I don't have the skills or whatever to do that, so I'm grateful to have Viventor here.
You're welcome to roll up a character for shits and giggles if you want to, John.
No, that's okay. This is sort of outside my. I'll just.
Fair enough.
Mind if I just chill with my mic muted?
Go for it. Enjoy. Yeah,
okay. Enjoy.
You can keep an eye on us and make sure we don't do anything too awful. Apart from Lothian, obviously.
Perhaps we could turn John into an NPC, the ruler of a land, perhaps.
probably not the ruler of your land, because I've already designed that person.
Oh, V, could you send me? Did you put up the links? Could you resend me the links to the just so I can see I'm just curious the materials you put together for the setting.
Oh yeah, sure. Give me a second. Just read this. And my USB issue came up right at that second. Mm. John, they're pinned in the on the channel list thing, the bob at the top.
So I'm actually looking at my Stilted now. I've realized I've now taken 5 schools of magic.
Wow.
So you're a mage, basically.
I'm half tempted to rename diplomacy to diplomancy now.
Gandalf.
I was tempted to do that, so that you're not the only one to think of that.
Diplomancy, I like that.
Right. You've got no bonuses to your physique, so you've got 2 health stress boxes. You've got a bonus to will, which gives you 3 stress boxes. You've got magical stress boxes at 4 with your psychomancy, and no armor skill whatsoever, so no armor.
Yeah,
so far, nobody has gone with armor. I'm kind of impressed.
Big scary Drake thing.
Oh yeah, yeah. Yeah,
we'll be fine.
I can run really fast, guys. I'll be fine.
Yeah, the cat person with 6 health boxes. I mean, what the?
I still want to die.
Is six a lot in this game?
Yeah, the highest you're supposed to be able to get is 4. She managed to find me messing up in the rules so she can get 6.
Exploit for the win in every game. It's what I do.
Well, I did consider a way where using in a certain circumstance, I would end up with a +8 roll to my diplomacy. So.
Oh, yeah. There are circumstances in which you'll get that. And that is on the rolling table, on the table there, a legendary roll.
A legendary diplomat.
Yep.
So all the lands should know of him.
Okay. Stubbs.
Baromancy.
Yeah, that's your ability to manipulate smells, which sounds completely useless, but is going to fuck so many people over if you do it right.
Yeah, I can see.
Yes. So first things first at the start.
The practical joke possibilities are practically endless.
Oh, I know. Yes.
It's also good for poison. I mean, if you have a poison that smells bad, you just make it smell good.
There you go. Yeah.
Or perhaps
you could clear out fancy buildings so I could steal things.
Sorry, what did you say, Ronald?
If you manipulate the smell inside of a court to be something sweet and gentle, relax everyone's minds.
And not let them smell the poisonous smoke rising around them.
Yes. Let them smell the rat sneaking up behind them.
Or hide your smell from wild animals as you travel through the wilderness.
I was going to say, if someone was like hunting you down with hounds or something, you could make the hounds go nuts.
I do have to ask. Would my psychomancy work on wild animals, or do they not have the level of reason?
It depends on the animal. Because you can insert a thought into a mind, which, even for an animal, will give you the ability to just insert a thought. Like, they might not understand a concept like friend, but they could understand a concept like food.
Or sleep. go to sleep.
Say the rat would taste disgusting.
Mm-hmm.
Useful. All right, mm-hmm. So the stunts.
So, you want to have all the magical stunts, don't you?
All of them. All four.
Okay. I recommend you do that, then.
Shall I just copy and paste all of them in?
Yeah, you can do that. That's the easiest way of doing it. There's an awful lot of text there, so you might want to cut out the extra stuff if you don't want the bump you want to put in. It's pretty self-explanatory what it does once you are aware. If you have any questions about the magical stuff, feel free to ask. I will explain it to the best of my ability. Which, considering I'm the one who came up with this system, I'm going to have to do. But yeah, in theory, you could do a magical effect which required a +8 roll reliably, because you can add 4 to your roll by burning 1 stress box. That's insane. You are ridiculously powerful in your psychomancy. You're very powerful in your biomancy. You're bloody powerful, but not quite as powerful as the biomancy and chronomancy. And your lunomancy and pyromancy are both pretty damn good.
So what you're saying is you made another accidental boss character.
Oh, no. He's balanced because he's only got 2 health.
And yet I'm broken.
Oh yeah, because he'll die in 2 hits.
Oh, could you give me a link? Oh, never mind. There it is. I was about to ask about the map, but I see you've posted that already.
Don't worry. And the map is pretty fucking big. I used a generator called Donjon Fantasy World Generator. That stuff is really useful because you also
Donjon Fantasy World Generator.
Fantasy.
Well,
yeah. Let me give you a link to it, actually, if you give me a second.
A fancy world generator would also be nice.
It's so fancy. I'll put it into
the fancy world generator.
So fancy.
Only the most luxurious of magical realms.
It's full of grey poupon.
Of course, I can, of course, very easily be killed by punched in the face a couple of times.
Yeah.
But people have to come back to their own minds, their own bodies being broken down, burning,
or maybe I can
blinded,
be cringed to death.
Of time.
What we do is you hide behind the cart and just throw fireballs at people.
Actually, guys, let's give John a quick rundown of all our characters. So let's start with Sasha and Lily, if you could.
Okay. I made a rat that was the son of a rich merchant who ended up becoming a hedonistic, hopeless romantic.
That's sweet.
That's it. Oh, yeah, I can describe it in as few words as possible.
Sentuous.
I'm an Assassin's Creed. Yeah.
Cool. I love this.
Who is incredibly bulky. We have it's an incredibly bulky cat who has +6 to their physique, so basically is almost indestructible.
Yeah, I've seen some big ass cats.
Kitty Smash.
I'm the Hulk of cats.
they can
I'm
She
Hulk the cat version. That's really good at stealth.
So yeah, we have a really high stealth rating and massive physique, and only 5 foot tall. So you have this...
So you're a short tank rogue.
you're basically a fantasy dwarf cat.
Hey. I'm 5'10", okay?
Oh, you're 5'10". I thought you said 5 foot.
No.
Well, I'm only 5'7", so...
Okay. Basically, imagine Gimli with a tail.
Now you're all just being me!
Oh, guys, let's leave the party fights until the actual game, okay?
Well, now I feel like I should make my character taller now.
No, you don't have to worry about it. Don't forget, you can be as variable as you like. You could be the same height as our rat guy, who is 3 foot something?
4'8". Let me look it again. He is 4'3".
4'3". So, Ronald.
Yeah.
Shall we continue?
Indeed.
Okay. So, you've taken three stunts, so your refresh is going to be three, and you have three fate points. And my mouse just stopped working for a second. Okay, extras. Okay, I just need to put sashes up so I can see what layout I did for equipment last time. Okay, so you want weaponry. You have no weapon skills, so you have no weapons.
Yes, I'm relying purely on my magical ability currently.
I'm guessing you're going to have a smart diplomat's outfit.
Yes, functional.
How smart? Is he going to be like robbed when we walk down the street?
Maybe.
I mean, as a learned man, one has learned to take function over form.
Now, I'm going to say that you can have the same amount of gold as Sasha's character, which is now named Clunny Gurfang.
Clunny!
I'm just going to kill Fang. Fangworks.
Fanganetta.
Exactly.
Anyway, so I'm going to say you can have 50 gold, but you can draw upon a promissory note on behalf of your government. You can spend up to 500 of your government's gold.
However, that will annoy my court enemies even more, I'm sure.
Yep.
That's a lot of gold.
Oh, so when you said, like, diplomat, you meant, like, literally, like, he's in the employ of...
Yeah, I am an envoy of the court.
Okay, cool.
It would be a shame if that promissory note disappeared.
It would be. But he can write his own promissory notes, that's the thing. He can draw on a maximum of 500 gold in promissory notes.
But it's also it's got diplomacy and psychomancy, so you can make the shopkeepers think he's already paid them.
Manipulative, yes. However, once again, my honour, those contain me once again.
It does indeed. Now, let's have a look at what skills you do have. You have sketch, so we'll give you a sketchbook and pencils or... Yeah, pencils. Ignore my god-awful spelling.
Sorry.
Well, this map is huge.
Scare us all, why don't you?
Look, I scared myself, okay?
What did you do?
I have enough nail polish.
Hey, but did you see my character?
Wow. I have no... okay.
Yeah, exactly.
Greatest disaster ever.
It is.
It is, yeah.
Clear nail polish everywhere.
Okay. Yeah, I think that's okay for your equipment right now, because you don't really need much equipment with your magical ability.
I assume then magic is purely from an internal source then, rather than through tools or equipment.
And here's where I get to explain something. So, there is such a thing as a wand or a stave. However, wands are more common and are simply magical focuses in a small stick. As a rule, they are only useful in combat for casting magic. Each wand is optimized for a certain type of mancy, and will work with other types, but with a minus one as strong as its natural element. So basically, if it's a plus one wand of pyromancy, it will be a minus one wand of cryomancy and all the others. So it will take off one point of skill if you try and use it for the other one.
So it's a magical artifice foci, essentially.
Yeah. Staves are rarer and react to all forms of magic equally. In theory, somebody without magical skill could pick up a stave and cast any form of magic at plus one level.
So if I was to, say, find a psychomancy wand and spend a single one of my magic stress boxes, what would my skill level be then?
It depends on what your role would be, but yeah, you could potentially be absolutely insane if you ever find a wand.
Yes.
And they go all the way up to plus four. However, quote, +4 wands have never been seen. Anybody who has found one would rival the most powerful magic users in the world. So yeah, there are people out there who genuinely do have those things.
Maybe a dragon would know.
That's a possibility.
I mean, we have characters with underworld contacts, and I have court contacts. Sure. Mm-hmm.
See how that goes for you.
Poorly, I'm sure.
Well, let's put it like this. +4 staves cannot exist. Right? Just say, the people who hold those things, you probably don't want to mess with. Ever.
Right, then.
Okay, height. How tall is your character?
One moment, allow me to check my species.
Okay.
Okay, so while he's checking, I have a quick question.
Go for it.
Can I have a forgery skill?
Not at present, but when you do your next character upgrade, so your character level up, we can talk about doing it.
Got it.
All right. It says average to tall, so I'm actually going to say I'm about 6'1".
Okay, that works for me.
I changed my height, so I'm taller than you now.
So now the cat is not a midget with strength. It's
I'm now 6'10".
The cat is no longer as wide as it is tall.
There's a spiraling height arms race. It's going to overtake the whole party now.
Oh, just wait. The last person is going to be a drake, which is basically the dragonborn. They can be up to 8-foot tall.
Uh-oh.
That'll be the second tallest. It's
what
fine.
These likes.
So, if you put your height down in the box at the bottom there.
I think I'm wrong.
You with us, Ronald?
Yes, sorry. In order to type, I have to not press my push to talk button because it is.
Sorry. You don't have fur, unlike the other two characters we've done so far. But you will.
Me. Nobody stand on the rat.
You are going to be fairly dark skinned. You're going to be somewhere between a. I suppose you could be somewhere between a Middle Eastern to all the way into a very dark, almost completely black skin tone. Because that's the defining colour of the Hermian's skin.
Do you know the guy from Mr. Robot?
Not off the top. Oh, yeah, I think I do.
Kind of like that. A dark olive, perhaps.
Mr. Robot, let me just double check.
That guy also played the mummy guy in, what's it called? Night at the Museum. And he also is...
Yes, he was the Pharaoh, I believe.
Yeah, Pharaoh. And he also played, he's also in, what's that game? That horror game that everyone loves about? It's on the PlayStation 4. Name escapes me.
I know you mean it's
the story one or whatever.
Yeah, it's called Wendigo in it.
It's called something.
I only
Until Dawn.
There it is.
I only just noticed in chat what Tanis Eaton said, the +4 stave of don't piss off Gandalf.
Yep.
We have a dragon Gandalf.
It's not a dragon.
Oh, you're a normal human.
Yep.
I thought you were the dragon.
No, I am. Oh, I'm a Dreyek, so I'm related to dragons in some way.
Yeah. So, eye colour is the last thing we need from you, and a name.
Well, I think it wouldn't exactly suit the character if he was to have... Although perhaps the magical aspect would suggest, as you mentioned earlier, the magic seems to have had altered effects on people's physical appearance. So perhaps a standout characteristic as such. Some strange eye colour, perhaps a bright yellow or
bright yellow, could
perhaps even approaching gold.
So you're going to look like a toilet.
Going to look like a what?
What?
Like, you know,
we're not entirely sure.
Okay. Pretty gold looking, nice. Like a yellowy gold.
There we go. I think that's your character pretty much done then. Just need to think of a name. And I just
random
need to stop
name
dying.
Generator for the win.
Yeah, there is a random name
yes,
generator.
Yes, why are you dying, Vivantar?
Because
have you not taken care of yourself?
No, my cough has been around since December, and the blasted thing will not go away, being very annoying. And of course, this happens. This of course happens at the same time.
That long.
Yeah, this is of course happens at the same time as my local hospital is currently having an absolute crisis because of chronic underfunding. Anyway, moving on. Wolf Venom, would you like to do your character next?
Okay.
Oh, is Wolf Venom back yet?
Yeah, I might have to refresh.
Yeah, he's.
Yes, yeah, so, sorry, I just scrolled down in the chat and noticed, oh, toilet break. And I was like, oh, did I literally just pick the map? Law of Sod.
Been back for a while now.